Previously on BMP.
I think we're stuck in here. The only way out is going to be to shoot our way out. Check your ammo. Alright, you ready? On my mark. 3, 2, 1.
Hello.
Lacey, you've got to get out now. There's a bomb in the studio.
Oh my God.
What should we do, Mr. President?
Pray.
We have no choice. Fire the missiles.
Hit the fourth floor, please.
Kristen, BMP.
Yeah, Kristen. Yeah, I need to pass through the door.
For a door?
It's not opening.
According to my computer, you just need to push.
Push? Oh.
Kristen, BMP.
It's me. Listen, I need those photos now.
Sat photos?
No, I need the satellite photos of Jessica Alba in her backyard uploaded to me right now.
Ooh, okay. I'll upload it to your PDA. Okay.
Yeah? I really don't know what to do. I feel like there's someone out to get me. I feel like I'm being followed all the time.
Lauren, wake up. We're about to start.
That was weird.
Celebrity news this week, Tom Cruise and Katie Holmes are finally going to tie the knot, and they are going to do it in Italy next month. The wedding will take place with the traditional vows, dresses, and reception, all done celebrity style. The honeymoon destination is currently unknown. Although what is known is that due to religious reasons, Katie Holmes will have to give a silent wedding night. Any moans or screams will upset the mighty gods of Tom Cruise, who will then come to life and smite the nearest living marsupial, and nobody wants to see that happen.
Well, The Colonnade featured an article this week announcing the decision of the Wireless Communities Georgia program and the Georgia Technical Authority to award a grant to Milledgeville, allowing the city to install a wireless network to cover the town. The new network will allow wireless internet access from any area in the new or historical downtown areas. Finally, now I can watch porn and duel it out with other fire mages in Azeroth from the comfort of any public place.
A father in Philadelphia is in prison this week after pulling a gun on his son's football coach. The man, Wayne Dercoch, was arrested after an altercation with the coach of a 6- and 7-year-old football team. Mr. Dercoch was upset over the amount of playing time his son was getting. If he is pulling a gun on a 6- and 7-year-old's football coach, then I would hate to be the one to tell him that his son is playing Tinkerbell in the school production of Peter Pan.
Well, Claudia Schiffer made a bold statement this week, saying that current models are too skinny. Despite being petite herself, she claims that the current generation of skinniness, quote, doesn't look good anymore. Plus, she added, if all the other models get fat, my career won't be dead anymore. Here to comment more on the story is BMP's fashion consultant, Isaiah Dimitri Bob.
Thanks. Fashion, a farce that has forced fine females to frantically find themselves versus far too fat for flattery. The terrible trend has trickled through time to tantalize teens, specifically young girls. Schiffer says suave, super skinny superstars seem to scare sensitive socialites into starvation, shrinking size, and supposedly securing popularity. I, however, propose that the unnecessary usurpation of young youth is completely catty, cruel, cruddy, crappy, calamitous, cold, crude, cruise, control, cut, clip,
whoa, whoa, whoa,
cake.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, Isaiah, the jig is up. Take off that silly disguise. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you none other than Alliteration Man in disguise.
He's right. I am Alliteration Man, and I would have gotten away with this if it weren't for you meddling kids. Well, either way, mark my alliterated words, I will weep and wail without warning till BMP is wiped out. I will get you, BMP.
Well, that was a little weird. Moving on, according to Reuters, a 52-year-old man in Germany followed the commands of his GPS navigation system a little too closely and ran into a construction site. Apparently, when the GPS said turn right, the man instantly turned, crashing into a row of portable toilets used on the site. Uh-oh, Lauren. I think it's time for another BMP joke-off. This time, though, we'll make the freshman interns duke it out. The winner doesn't have to shave Tyler Flowers' back.
Hey, I'm Frank the Tank.
And I'm Kristen.
And this is the joke-off to see who gets to shave Tyler Flowers' back. I guess I'll start. You could say he was a crappy driver, huh?
Okay, my turn. I guess his friends weren't kidding when they said his driving stinks.
It was a good one. You could say his driving records were in the toilet.
Or you could say his reckless driving left a streak of skid marks.
Either way, the guy is covered in human feces and urine, and there's poop on his car.
Okay, Frank, you win, but only so we don't have to hear another crappy joke.
Now we're going to send it over to our correspondent, Tyler Flowers, for everyone's favorite portion of the week, the vent section. Tyler, what you got for us this week?
Appreciate it. You know what really mockles my Jackson? It's people who are rude. I mean, here we are. We're in Georgia, and we're supposed to have Southern hospitality. But I guess I shouldn't complain too much, because good old Georgia College had a visitor this week. I feel we've welcomed him quite well.
Why can't we be friends? 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 I seen ya around for a long, long time. I really remember when you drank my
Thanks, Tyler. We all look forward to your segment every week.
You don't look enthused.